Hey guys, today I'm going to teach you exactly how to make a crib board out of a slab of wood that you can buy pre-made, pre-cut at Home Depot. I'm just going to show you how to lay out the crib board. If you don't want to listen to my introduction, please just watch Jesus himself play hockey in the background while I go over a few things before I get started. Like I said, you don't actually need a whole lot of skills to do this as far as woodworking. You're just gonna need a drill and a bit and to actually do a little bit of math. You can get the kit at Home Depot to cut one of these slabs down for you, and you're gonna need for it to be at least 30 inches and up to maybe 36. Anything beyond that, based on the math that I'm gonna show you for the layout, is gonna look kind of weird. So, I mean, to each their own, but figuring out where to put all the holes is really the only hard part about this. It gets all beautiful mind in your head and you're looking at all these marks, and you will certainly screw it up because there's just so much that you're looking at. And so I've tried to make it really easy for you guys to follow. And now, these slabs at Home Depot are fairly expensive. I think this was about $170 Canadian just for this slab. If you want to buy the legs that come with these things just to screw on, that's an extra $100. So you could build two tables for $540, which is quite a bit of money. But one thing that I do promise you is that if you do make one of these and actually do a fairly good job with it and have it in your house and post it on Facebook or Instagram, I almost assuredly can say to you that you will be able to sell one to some rich douchebag that just said something kind of like this. He said, you know, this pandemic's been really tough on my family because we've been cooped up in our mansion for so long. So what we decided we needed to do was that we needed to get a place out at the lake just so we could escape because everything's so tough in our lives right now. And I guarantee one of those douchebags will buy one of these things off you for like $400 or $500. And now you've got yours for free, plus you've made a little cash during the pandemic. If I was gonna make a bunch of these, what I would do is I would do the template out of a piece of plywood and then drill the holes in it, and then you can just mark it and go, and you'll never screw up. Because if you try to do this without following the instructions or with different measurements, then it gets just super weird in your head and you'll look at all these lines and you'll be like, what the hell, I might have missed something, and you don't want to screw it up. So hopefully I made it really easy to understand. If you like this video, please subscribe. We'd love to have you, and we'd love to do more with this channel in the new year, and especially once we get out of the pandemic times. So let's start getting into the marking. So now what I want to do before I actually start drilling the holes is what I want to make sure is that I do not drill holes where the lines are. You know on crib boards how it goes 5 and then there's a line which says the numbers, which is the space, and then the next 5? I want to make sure that I don't drill in those lines. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take one of my son's crayons and I'm going to draw on these. And it doesn't matter that there's marks on there because we are going to sand this all off later before we finish it, which I'll show you how we do that. I just want to make sure that I do not drill in the wrong spot. Now once you start drilling, and I'm going to show you, and it takes longer but it will look better, I promise, is that you are going to drill sort of offline if you don't preset a hole for your Forstner bit. So what I'm going to do is actually sit there and take a small little finishing nail and a hammer and hammer in a little starting hole in each spot. And then I'm going to do the Forstner bit. That way all the lines will be straight. It will look great once it's finished. And that way you can sell it for more money. So on your first attempt for your house, it's not as big of a deal, but you'll see, you'll get the hang of it, and let's just go to the next steps. Alright, so those holes took the better part of an hour. It's a pain in the ass. It hurts your back. So hopefully you can follow my instructions pretty easily. Only have a few more steps. And while I do these next steps, I'm obviously going to listen to my favorite financial planning channel because that's super fun to listen to financial planners talk about money. I'm just kidding. I'm going to change the channel immediately. But I thought that was a pretty easy, shameless plug. First, I'm going to do the numbers, the finish, the start line. I was going to do it with paint. I've burned them in before, like a wood-burning pen. But I think today I'm going to try an actual black pencil crayon because the paintbrushes that I have are all my son's and they're not very good. So I don't think I'll do a very good job with the stencil. After that, I've obviously got to put in the 4 peg holes, or the 6 peg holes actually, 2 for each one before the start line. And then I need to paint the pegs different colors, so I'll go through that. You obviously don't need instructions on that. I'm going to put the legs on, and I had already built these, and I mean built, it didn't really do anything. It was just cedar, a piece of cedar that I had. And I had it on another piece of wood that I was going to use as a table that I didn't like. And it turns out it's going to work perfectly for this thing. So I'm not going to have to buy or teach you how to make legs. If you want to make legs out of like 2x4s or 6, I'm sure you can find another video on YouTube. Somebody teaching you how to make cheap, nice looking legs. I think if you spray paint them black, they do look really good. And I'll show you in another video when I finish, maybe a cookie slab. I've been doing a whole bunch of those tables. And then lastly, I'm just going to finish it, and that should be it. So I'll talk about how I'm going to finish it when I get to that step. And so thank you guys very much for watching. I'll come see you at the end, and please subscribe. And if you really want and you're Canadian, check out K4 Financial. It's my financial planning channel. Thanks again.